You don't always have to use sprites in your game. Game Maker allows you to draw other kinds of shapes using certain functions, and I'll show you those inside this object. This object, Object Draw Shapes, inside the draw event, because that's where you have to do all of your draw functions and they can't go in any other event. Let me just show you the room here. This object doesn't have a sprite, it's just going to sit dead center in my room. And inside, I've got a whole bunch of stuff that's commented out, so we'll go through one at a time. Now the first one is draw arrow. Now, draw arrow needs all these arguments down here. It needs an x and y 1 and an x and y 2. This is the starting point of the arrow and the ending point of the arrow, and the size is how big the arrow tip will be. So let's just take a quick look at this arrow and see what it looks like by default. Here it is. It's black. It started here at this position. I drew it all the way down to here, and the size of the arrowhead, let's go back to it. I started at the center of the room, that's where my x and y coordinate is for this object, and I drew it 150x, 150y, so down here. 32, if we go back to the game, is how big this arrowhead is. It's how many pixels from the head to the base of the arrow. This is 32 pixels. And then the width of this triangle or arrowhead is just based on how long you made the arrow. Now, black is hard to see. So once again, like in the draw text video, I've brought back this settings script. And I'm just going to set my alpha to 1, so fully opaque, and I'm going to set my color to white, so anything I draw will be white. So let's turn on the settings. And now when I run it, my arrow will be white, and there it is. Quite simply, so you just pick a spot where you want it to start, a spot where you want it to end, and no problem. You can even have the tip of this animate. You can have it mapped to the x and y coordinate of a moving object, and it'll always point towards it. You can have this be where your player is, and the tip be where an enemy is, and you can just follow it around. So let's move on to draw circle. So this is quite simple. You pick the center of the circle. I'm going to put it at the x and y coordinate of my object, which is 320 and 320, x, 320y, you know, in the room. Then the radius of the circle, I'm going to make it 64, and whether or not you want it to just be the outline of the circle. For this, I'm saying true. I just want to draw the outline. Let's take a look at it and see what we can do. So there's our circle. It started here, right at the x and y coordinate of the object, went 64 this way, drew the circle, and only shows the outline. Of course, I could make it false, and then it would fill in the entire circle. Draw circle color is the same concept, and I'm going to make it the same size. I've got the center, x and y, the radius being 64, except now you get to pick two colors. One is the color at the center of the circle, two is the color at the outermost region of the circle, and it'll just blend together as a gradient. This time, when it asks outline, I'm going to say false. I want it to be a full filled in circle. So there it is. We've got the circle in the same spot. It's filled in and it starts with the lime green and goes out to the dark green. There we go. Just a nice gradient circle. Nothing special about it. But there are more options for circles, really ellipses. Now ellipses are not perfect circles. They're like ovals or eggs. So in this case, you don't pick a center and a radius, you pick where the top left corner of the bounding box will be, and the bottom right corner of where the bounding box will be, and a circle will be drawn in the middle of it. And when circles are drawn, you can use this setting, draw set, circle precision, and this is how many points there are in a circle. Now a square has 4 points. When drawing a circle on a computer, it's really just drawing a square with so many points, you know, a square or a pentagon, octagon, just it keeps increasing depending on, you know, pentagon, octagon, until it has so many points that it's actually becomes smooth. It becomes a circle because there are so many points. Like if I had 256 points, it'd be a really smooth circle. So let me show you what that looks like. Let's actually go back to our colored circle, and I'm going to tell it to only use 4 points, so now it'll look like a square. There it is. So instead of a circle, I've told it to only use 4 points when drawing this circle, and you can see it's now a diamond or a square or a parallelogram or whatever you want to call it. So you can always set how many edges, how many vertex, how many points, the points on the edge of your shape. And you don't always have to do that. That's just available if you need to. Sometimes you can lower the number so it takes less computing power to make these shapes. Now an ellipse, though, as I was saying, is more like an egg. So I've picked the top left corner and the bottom right corner of my bounding box, and I'm going to say that I don't want it to be outlined. I want it to be a full shape, fully filled in, and this is what it looks like. There it is. So I picked this as my top left, and then I stretched it over here as my bottom right, and it just drew a curve all the way around that bounding box. Once again, I could use the precision to set how precise it is. It can look like a square again if I wanted it to. But in this case, I'm just going to keep it nice and default curved, and it's kind of like an egg. Since it's kind of like an egg, for the next one, you're allowed to add color. So it's the same thing where you put the top left and the bottom right coordinate. I'm going to put them in the exact same spot, except now you get to pick two colors. And once again, it blends from the middle color to the outer color. So I'm going to start as yellow in the middle, like yolk, and white on the edges. And once again, false for the outline. I want it to be fully filled in. And here's what it looks like. There we go. I started with yellow in the middle. It's a gradient out to white on the edge, just like an egg. And it's not a perfect circle. It's an ellipse. It's just a curved, filled in shape. And there we go. We can do color or non-color, or whatever you need to do. The next set over here, I've got lines. For this, you pick where you want the line to start and where you want it to end. It's that simple. It's kind of like the arrow. It's just there's no arrow head. So I've decided I'm going to start at 0, 0, which is going to be the top left of my room. That's where 0, 0 is on the axis. And I'm going to do room width and room height. So the maximum height and width of the room. It's going to draw diagonally across my room. Here's what that looks like. And here it is. It started at 0, 0, went down to the room's width and height. It's in white because of my settings. And it's only 1 pixel in width, which isn't very good for us. And there are other ways to change it, and we'll get into it. But here's the same one, but we just add color. And once again, you start with a color at your first point, and you end with a color at your second point. This time I changed the points around. I'm going to start at the room width over here, and at 0y, and go all the way down to 0 and room height. So it's just a diagonal line facing the opposite direction, starting at white, blending to black. There it is. It's kind of hard to see, but it starts at white, blends all the way down to black, but it's only 1 pixel wide, and that's why it's hard to see. So let's learn another function called drawLineWidth. Same thing, get to draw the line as before, but now you actually get to set the width in pixels, and I've chosen 8. So it's going to be the same as before, and you know what? Let's just put both lines on the screen. So this will be the line that started here and went down this way, and the line that started here and went down this way. One was pure white, one was white to black, except now they both have a width of 8. So they'll be more visible to us. And there they are. I've got up here, down here, there's my white line, and up here to down here, that's my white to black, and they both have a width of 8 pixels, so they're a little more visible. And, you know, sometimes you want to draw lines, depending on what kind of game you're making. Now, let's look at draw point. Now, draw point is just 1 pixel. I'm just going to draw it right where I am. It's going to be white color. It's going to be nothing fancy. And let's draw point with color, except let's offset it. I'm going to move it 32 pixels to the right of my X position. So I'll draw one dot in the center of the screen, and 32 pixels over will be another dot, except I'm going to make it lime colored. So here's what those 2 points look like. I'm going to zoom in here because it's hard to see, but there's my white point, and there's my lime green point, 32 pixels to the right, and that's it. This is how you draw 1 point, 1 pixel. There's no changing this width, because truthfully, if you want to change the width, you're making a circle or a square. So we've already covered those functions. We got the circles over here, and let's cover the rectangles. So we've got rectangle and rectangle color. So as before, you just pick the top left corner and the bottom right corner, and the box will be drawn, and whether or not you want it to be filled in. So I'll leave this plain colored one. Obviously, it's going to be white. It's not going to be anything special. So let's include these 4 arguments to this function. So we need x1, y1, that's the top left, x2, y2, that's the bottom right, and then each corner gets its own color. So I'm going to do C white, C red, C green, C blue, all the way around, and they'll all just blend together. And I won't do an outline so we can actually see the colors blend together. And here's what it looks like. Here's my beautiful box. I've got the white corner here, the red corner here, the green corner here, and the blue corner here. That's how it's drawn. It goes to the right, goes down to the left, and goes up. And that's it. This is my first point, my second point. That determines how big the square is. and they're just colorful, all blended together. Now we have a rounded rectangle. It's exactly like a rectangle, but instead of coming to a perfect 90 degree point, we round the edges of the corners. So to do it, it's the same thing as a rectangle. We just pick the top left corner, the bottom right corner, and whether or not you want it filled in, so nothing special there. This, by the way, is also somewhat affected by draw set circle precision on how precise the curve is. But using this function with the extended portion of it, we can do that inside the function. I'll get to that in a sec. So I've got draw round rectangle with color. It's the same way we drew the color for the rectangle before, but now we're going to draw it with rounded edges, and here's what it looks like. Here we go. It started with the color in the center, and it blended out to the color on the edge, kind of like how we did with the circle instead of the rectangle, and it has rounded edges instead of perfect 90 degree cuts. Now there's more to it. We can do this extended version, and I'll do the color one because it always looks cooler. We just pick top left corner, bottom right corner, and this time we pick the radius of the X and the Y. This is how curved it is on the X axis, how curved it is on the Y axis. Let's do something weird. Let's do 64 curve for X and only 4 curve for the Y. And it's going to blend from the center to the outside again, just like that circle. And outline, let's do false so we can fill it in and see what it looks like. There we go, I made it much larger this time, but it blends from white to black, just like that. And you see how it's not really curved, not really anything, these weird jagged points? It's because I didn't pick two of the exact same number. So one plane is trying to curve, and the other plane's not trying to curve by much. But we could always do it the same way. Let's do 128 for both, and that'll be much more curved. There we go, it's so curved, it's now a circle. That's how much into each plane it curved. Now, we may not want to do that. Usually, you want to keep it somewhere, you know, maybe around the same. 128 is the entire size of this rectangle. So let's only do half and see what that looks like. Here we go. So we have a nice rounded edge. It doesn't go all the way to the center because that produced a circle. It only goes right here, quarters. So that's it. Actually looks really nice. I could pick different colors and make it look nicer, but you know, that's the basics of a rounded rectangle. It's just like a regular rectangle, but with rounded corners. Now we can draw triangles. For this, you simply decide where the first point will be, the second point, the third point, wherever those three points will be, and it closes them up, and you decide whether you want it just to be an outline or to be filled. And for this one, let's just say true. Let's just do an outline and take a look at what this circle is. That's my first point, the X and Y, second point X and Y, and third point X and Y. And here's what it looks like. This is it. Started here, went down over here, and then automatically closed it back up to the first point. And that's it. That's my triangle. I said that it was true for the outline. I don't want to fill it in. But if you do want to fill it in, you might want to decide to use colors. So it's the same thing. I've actually made it a bit better. Instead of going to 360, it goes to 600, so it widens out the base of this triangle. And the first point will be white, the second will be fuchsia, and the third will be orange. You'll get this nice kind of creamy blend between these three colors. And of course, false for the outline, because we want to see what the filled-in version of this triangle looks like. And here it is. My first point is white, then I went to the fuchsia point and the orange point, and it creates kind of this like sorbet or sherbet kind of color mix going on. It makes me kind of hungry for, you know, eating some sort of treat. But that's it. We've got draw triangle, rounded rectangles, regular rectangles, points, let's put that D back, it's just one pixel. We can draw lines, whether it's one pixel or we define our own width. We can do circles that are perfect or ellipses that don't have to be perfect. They can be oblongs like ovals and whatnot. And we can always set how many points there are in our circles, which does seem to affect just a regular rounded rectangle without the extended portion of the function. And we can draw an arrow if for some reason you need to draw an arrow. And that's it. These are some of the basic shapes you can draw inside GameMaker.